Let's now dive a bit deeper into how we can mobilize resources to solve the pressing problems of our communities. Drawing upon decades of studying how leaders create progress, I see leading change as actually a six-step circular process. Number one, you assess community dreams and needs in an open and inclusive manner. Two, craft a shared vision that incorporates what we've learned using visioning techniques. Three, share this vision as widely as possible to gather others. Here we'll practice the skills of storytelling. Four, we create a small related project or prototype to support that vision. Our module on project planning will support this step. And then we reflect what we've learned and use that information to refine our vision and plans. Number six, we pause and we celebrate successes, even small successes, which motivational leadership shows sustains a team and brings others into a positive, gratitude-focused mindset. And number seven, we head right back up to step one as we assure that our vision and our approach are aligned with what we've learned, and we try again with another project, moving our dream closer to reality. Success with steps one and two is dependent on us being open and inclusive leaders. I want to pass along two more metaphors to support us as we practice being inclusive leaders. In the Hindu tradition, the universe has been described as a great living being, and you can consider that I may be sitting on the end of a fingernail and you may be on the end of a hair. And by us listening to each other, we get a better sense of the whole, so we make better decisions. This can be a helpful way of seeking out diverse opinions and questioning my assumptions. What am I seeing? What am I seeing? Another is to think of all of us in an infinitely high tower, and we're each looking out a window. So for me, my window may be wonderful, especially if I'm part of a community's power structure. So for example, I might look out my window and say, there's so much opportunity. It's so easy to live here. Everyone is so nice. And I might see a sunny day where you may not be part of the power structure and are marginalized in some way. And you may say, there's no opportunity. I have no options. And this place, it's awful. So to be able to listen to multiple perspectives, even of those people that hate what I love, it makes it, it helps me to see this as another window, just another window. And if I can say, tell me more about why you think there's no opportunity, why you think someone or something is awful, things change. Looking for opposing views can be one of our most valuable leadership skills. But how do I actively seek out those opposing views? I need to be mindful of my own unconscious biases and beliefs that keep me from being curious about another person's window. Who do I shy away from? Who am I leaning into? Who do I think is worth listening to? What can others see that I cannot? Who am I asking to tell me more? As Microsoft founder Bill Gates shares, your most unhappy customer is your greatest source of learning. How are we doing that, looking to hear from our opponents in every way that we can? Meanwhile, we are most comfortable being around people who are like us, and in situations where we can be experts. It can be hard to say, tell me more, and to be open to the possible challenges or criticism. Here are four daily leadership tips that can help us to move from limited questioning and listening to a more expansive view. First, never solve a problem alone. Recognize that if you think you know an answer to a problem without consulting others, you're probably wrong. We always have a limited viewpoint. Ask at least one person who may have an opposing view about their experience and how they would solve a problem. Number two, Write out your assumptions about a situation or a person and check to see if they're completely true. Number three, ask others, what have I not considered? What am I missing? What am I forgetting? Who are we forgetting? And number four, notice how often you are surprised or find yourself challenging, wrestling with alternative views. If you're not often surprised and challenged, you're probably not in a fully inclusive or learning mode. All of these tips call us to be humble and aware that we as humans have blind spots and implicit biases that restrict our inclusion in of others and thus our success. I admire how the South African president, Nelson Mandela, was able to take his community from a great dream to implementation. I want to close with a few quotes that exemplify Mandela's inclusive host leadership philosophy. If you want to make peace with your enemy, you have to work with your enemy, and then he becomes your partner. And a concern for others in our individual and community lives would go a long way in making the world a better place we so passionately dream of. He also said, it is in the character of growth that we should learn from both pleasant and unpleasant experiences, and a good heart and a good head are a formidable combination. May your good heart and your good head bring us to greater success.